Let's do it.
I need to prove to myself that I can do it and that PVF wasn't wrong for hiring me to teach people on the internet how to cook things.
I'm here to help because I'm a rat, duh.
Hello, I'm Nicole Ego, Anton's daughter, clearly, and I heard that somebody is making ratatouille, my favorite dish. Don't mess it up, I'll be back to taste it, and if you do not do a good job, I think I might have Ember over here replace you.
Wee-wee.
Oh god. Kimmy, you can absolutely do this, and if Kimmy can do this, then any single one of you can do this.
That's rude. But true. In the movie Ratatouille, they're not making ratatouille exactly, they're making a variation of it called confit bialbi, and that was also developed by Thomas Keller for his restaurant French Laundry, Michelin-starred restaurant, and he also consulted on the film. So, confit bialbi, first step. We are going to half these bell peppers and scoop them out, get all the seeds out.
Perfect. Getting all the gross.
Ew, nasty. We are going to put these in the oven at 450 degrees for 15 minutes.
Perfect. So we'll just put them in there.
Next, we're gonna cut an onion.
Do you know how to properly cut an onion?
I do now. I do now.
Wow.
I feel like it's a common thing. People don't learn the proper way until later. First thing first, never cut off the root. If you wanna cry, cut it off, sure. But if you don't feel like sobbing, let's not cut it off. First things first, I'm just gonna cut this in half.
Yup.
And then kind of work. I might have chosen the wrong knife for this endeavor, right? What's wrong with me?
Not going so well, huh?
It was a little hard. I used the wrong knife. That was my bad.
I wonder if I should try on this hat since
no!
It's
Ember, no! This is my job, French Ember. Back to the freaking onion.
Oh my god.
First things first, be very careful when you're cutting, obviously. Use the guiding knuckles. All right, I'm gonna cut off that bottom part just to help get the skin off easier. Peel this sucker off. You're gonna cut in towards the onion and kind of work your way around, like orange slices or something. You know what I mean?
Oh, yes.
So you work around, don't cut all the way to the root.
Mm-hmm. Is that hard to do with long nails?
A little bit. Yeah, the guiding knuckle thing really wasn't intended for people with long ass nails. Then you grip the onion and you work your way down. This looks so awkward. This
the claw
of safety. For this recipe, you only need about half a cup. So this is a half cup.
Great.
I'm gonna drop it in there.
I'm gonna show you how to peel, seed, and dice a fresh tomato. I kind of cut a little crosshair into the top, like so.
Cool.
And then we're gonna drop it in boiling water for like literally 10 to 15 seconds.
Yep.
It is not very long. And as soon as I pull it out, we're gonna put it into an ice bath.
Ooh.
I'm gonna just throw this in here into my boiling water. It's probably been about 10 seconds.
Yeah, probably. We can take her out.
Yeah. Right into that.
Cute.
So it's been like about a couple minutes, and hopefully this skin should just, oh yeah, it's already peeling.
Oh wow, look at that.
Yeah. And see how that skin is just literally peeling right off.
Ooh, baby. Look at her,
yeah.
She's perfect.
All right, so now we have our peeled tomato.
How is it going, ladies?
Oh, hi!
It's very nice.
Yeah, we're doing so good.
You don't think I should get my hopes up?
You absolutely should never do that, Ember.
I need to do this, I need to prove it to you.
It's very hard to cut the tomato.
It is?
I was the one in the kitchen who had to cut the tomato.
It is hard?
When we came to ratatouille for PVF, but then you have to separate every part.
Okay. So,
well, easy for Ash to do. Maybe
yeah, I
make
know.
Kimmy do it.
She's.
Why is not Kimmy doing it? Let Kimmy do it. Did you know Thomas Keller, who made the ratatouille that is in the movie, the animators actually went and worked in his kitchen.
Really?
They learned how to make the ratatouille in the kitchen. So they would know how to animate
it. I'm sorry.
When I did it, you had to then harvest all the seeds, separate the seeds from the juice, save the juice. Are you doing all of this?
Save the juice?
Yeah, of course we are.
Probably at home, if you wanted this properly, you can listen to her at this point.
That's what you don't want me to do.
Ever listen to her.
Never listen to her.
I'm just saying that's what I had to do, so I will tell Nicole.
Don't tell Nicole.
Anyway, we're dicing now.
We're gonna dice.
Do you two want to have a fun riddle?
A riddle?
Why not?
Okay, sure.
So a group of crows is a murder. A group of geese is a gaggle, no? That is a group of rats.
A raggle.
A rat-a-tat-tooey time.
No. A disgusting violation of health code.
It is called a mischief
mischief of rats.
That's what you are. You're a mischief.
Mischief of rats.
You're a mischief hood rat.
A mischief? A mischief? As much as Ember was taunting us there and not wanting us to succeed, truly, yeah, if you want to save the juices, I guess that is probably the way.
Save the juices.
You can get a cheesecloth or something, try and make sure you don't strain the seeds. Next up, all right, we have these tomatoes. Beautiful.
Love it.
Love it. I'll put them over here for now. Mm-hmm. It is probably time to pull our bell peppers out of the onion.
Oh, yes.
Out of the onion. Pull your bell peppers out
of
the onion.
Out of the onion.
So you want the skin to be kind of blackened slightly. So it makes
yeah.
it, ooh, look at her.
There we go.
Yeah, so it makes it nice and easy to peel off now this skin. We are gonna assemble the pie rod, which is basically the sauce that kind of goes underneath the beautiful, delicate ratatouille pattern you know and you love.
It should just kind of come right off, and then you get left with a fleshy pepper. Some olive oil. I'm gonna let that heat up. Do you know any French?
You know, I took a year of French, mm-hmm. but I was in middle school, and I'm like, my retention of anything from that time is so poor.
In middle school, absolutely not.
Je m'appelle Kimberly.
Kimberly.
Yeah, so je m'appelle.
Je m'appelle Ash.
Nice, nice. Je suis américain. It means I am American. Did you know that?
Je suis rat.
You know ratatouilles, there's just so many damn vegetables. I mean, the original ratatouille, like the actual recipe, is fried vegetables. So at least in this case, everything's kind of baked or,
yeah.
I mean, I guess pan-fried in this situation with some oil.
All right, you need this dice?
Yeah, we can dice that up.
Perfect.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. So next up, I'm gonna do my onion.
Yum.
And my garlic. I'm gonna let that cook a bit. We don't want them to be browned, but we do want them to be a little softened.
These peppers are slimy.
Throw the tomatoes in. Cool. This is gonna put in a decent amount of these. And some of the juices. Great.
Love it.
Ah!
What?
I'm hit!
Oh my god!
No, man, down!
Get down!
No, no. All right, so I've dropped tomato in, the juices. So now we have some herbs. So we got some thyme, parsley.
Herbs.
Thyme, parsley, and bay leaves. These are just going to cook with the dish. We're not gonna actually be eating these. Incorporate that in.
Mm-hmm. What about my peppers?
And your peppers come in a little later. Patience, rat. We're just gonna let this sit for about 10 minutes.
Great.
The bell peppers are going towards the end. It's basically we want these to get nice and softened to mix into our pie parade.
Hello?
You noticed me.
That's really kind. Thank you.
We oh my god.
It's Blanc 47.
Yeah, thank you so much.
It is Nicole Eagle's favorite wine.
Yeah, and it's like super expensive. It's so
nice
of you.
Yes, it is.
Wow.
I would love to give you the wine.
Great.
Yes,
we'll
take
you.
It.
It's really nice.
We'll take it.
Unfortunately, I'm not seeing the proper relationship from Ratatouille, my favorite French film.
I know where this is going.
It's okay. The best French film, as we know, French cinema is better, and the relationship between Lingenhall and Ratatat is very unique, and I don't see it represented here.
I mean, I don't really know how to
Because between the two of you, I do not see the teamwork.
I mean, I would argue we're
no!
doing this together. I can't.
I cannot put ash on my head under my hat and have her pull my hair like a marionette.
Can
sit on my shoulders.
Yeah.
What I mean, what other way is there to do this?
Yeah.
Hi.
So this does this do it for you? Does this feel accurate?
I have a strange power over them.
Ember, yeah, French Ember, sorry, French Ember. These are some interesting ingredients for an omelet.
Ah.
Is this from like the movie or something?
Oh, this is French. Ingredients.
Oh yeah?
Onions, zucchini, lettuce, butter, tomato, parsley, and fromage.
It's just me. I am so prepared to make an omelet for you.
Vite, do it quick.
Okay.
I count to 50.
All right, well, let's freaking go then. Okay, okay.
On this plate?
Yeah, okay, I guess we don't really, sorry. Oh wait, no, I freaking messed up. I messed up. So let's put some cheese in there. Yep. And then we're gonna put some, put some parsley in there. Beautiful, beautiful. I'm gonna reach for those tomatoes. So good, beautiful. Okay, and then you just kind of sprinkle them like so. All right, let's get some onion. And like probably a bunch, because Ember, I think, really likes onion.
Loves
an onion. Oh, and some butter. Next is the butter. And you just gotta mush it, yep. Just like this, see? Look how good I'm doing. We gotta squirt some honey mustard. And then we are gonna grab some zucchini over here, to the left, to my left, to my left, a little further. There you go. Gonna grab some of that, and then we're gonna throw that, and then left, and a little up, and then there's a lettuce. Just throw that in. Beautiful. We just crunch it up. Great. And then we are going to fold this omelet. Fold them over. Beautiful. Look at us go. Gorgeous.
Wow.
I think we're only doing... Oh yeah, the rat smokes. So my rat and I made this for you. I don't know if we can do four.
Ben and I will take it out.
Yeah, yum, yum, yum. You said you were so hungry.
I'm so hungry.
Mm-hmm. Aw, yeah. I mean, good. She's so hungry.
That was good. I give you the points for the teamwork.
Oh, great, thank you. And you loved it.
And I want this segment to be over.
Oh my God, I love omelets, don't you? It's so good.
Little rat, do you want some, chef?
Good. We both love it.
I bet you're gonna wait.
All right,
so
bye.
I will now give you the wine.
Oh, but Ember, that's beautiful. Wait, let's set this wine down.
No.
But Ember, give us a big hug.
Oh,
giant
okay.
hug.
I'll give you a hug.
Thank you for the wine.
Oh, yeah, no.
Wow. So glad Ember got some breakfast. It's been about 10 minutes with the piper rod. I added the last little bit of bell peppers in, so they're all nice and softened and incorporated.
Looks so good.
It does look really good. I'm gonna let that sit for just a little bit longer, just so they get nice and soft. In the meantime, truly this is the hardest part of making ratatouille. Our four different vegetables, to get them in the shape that we need them to be, we have to make super, super thin and even cuts. They also have to be around the same size when it comes to diameter. I wanted to show you guys a couple different ways to do it. If you have a mandolin, that is truly the easiest way to keep the cuts nice and even. But if you don't have a mandolin, you can use a knife.
Big thing about mandolins, they are very dangerous. I know several people that have cut their fingertips off.
No.
So you can actually get one of these handy dandy gloves. A lot of mandolins actually come with them, but it is to prevent any injury to your skin.
First, we have the eggplant. If you're gonna be making slices, again, hopefully you don't have long nails because it makes things harder. And then we're gonna make just the thinnest of slices. So if you care, it's 3 millimeters.
Sure.
If you care. So the eggplant's a little bit thicker. It's a little harder to cut through, so I'm just gonna kind of like serrate it down.
Yeah.
You guys know how to cut things, right? I mean, you wanna get a thin, even slice. For these, they kind of like, you want it to be a little bit see-through almost, like slightly, like you can kind of see the shadow behind it.
This mandolin is also set to 3 millimeters, and you get a really nice, even cut.
Nice and thin slices. We just wanted to show you guys how to do it. This is a cooking show where we do not have all the time, so I went ahead and had Chef Michael prep our vegetables for us. So we don't gotta worry about all that.
This is going to be our ratatouille tray for the day. Because we're really only making enough for one single human, which is Nicole, we aren't gonna make the full mm-hmm. size.
If you wanna make the full size, it's about an 8-inch like baking dish. So we have our pipe rod that's beautifully cooked down. Basically, we're just gonna do a nice thinnish layer on the bottom. We obviously don't want to leave any space.
Yeah.
The fun part.
What is our order here?
We're gonna do eggplant, yellow squash, zucchini, tomato. And look at that.
Beautiful.
You just go counterclockwise there and it's all beautiful. Action. Which I love because it's easy to forget things sometimes.
It is.
And you've done this before, so you kind of know the drill. So we're gonna start with the eggplant. Gonna put it off to the side. Nice.
Little layer.
So we probably want them to have about quarter inch of an overlap.
It would be pretty tight, right?
Yeah, I want to be pretty tight.
This is supposed to be perfect. Remember, it's going to Nicole Ego.
No, literally, I'm nervous already.
So scared.
No, I'm like, okay, so Nicole Ego, very intense, especially as Ego. I'm a little scared. I'm glad we have the wine to help, like, you know, soften her up a bit.
Loosen her up. Hopefully she can like suspend some judgment.
Hopefully. I really want to keep my job. Ember is so great at what she does, but also I like it here. I don't want to go. go yet. I never had had a ratatouille until trying this recipe that we are now doing.
Yeah?
Have you been to like a fancy French restaurant or just a fancy restaurant in general?
Well, I've definitely been to nicer restaurants. I'm a big steakhouse person. I love a good steakhouse. Yeah. I don't know if I've ever been to like a 5-star restaurant.
Have you been to a Michelin-starred restaurant?
And I feel like if I did, I would have remembered, you know?
You think.
I enjoy a good burger. I'm not always seeking out like fancy French food. I don't even know if I've ever been to a French restaurant, honestly.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, you should go.
I mean, I've never been to France. That's a lie. I've been to France.
Why did you lie to me just now about
I'm
that?
Sorry.
Oh my God.
Telling the truth is hard
it's
sometimes.
Really hard, huh?
You know, well, I don't know. You lie a lot because you don't cook everything that you make. It's always me.
What do you mean? Yes, I do.
It's always so ready in your hat.
You're right. No, you pull those strings.
Uh-huh.
And yeah. And my hair, which I don't always appreciate. Oh, wow. Oh, no. I lost control there. We're going to kind of make our inner circle using the same order.
It's going to stick up a little bit.
Yeah.
But it'll cook down.
I think it's just the same.
Yeah. Oh, there you go.
Kind of thing again.
That's
and then
gorgeous.
Layers it in.
Yeah.
So yeah, these are definitely like, because that pipe rod's like, you know, nice and soft and sticky, you can kind of.
Oh, there we go.
Cute. Oh, it's so cute. If you want to impress your friends, make this. I'm trying to impress Nicole out here, but look at these colors. It's so gorgeous.
The ingredients are so simple, but it's honestly all in the presentation.
I love like a flower.
Mm. Oh yeah, there you go.
Cool.
Wow.
Design. That was gorgeous.
You're gonna keep your job.
No, you
don't. You're gonna keep your job.
I just like when things are pretty.
Oh yeah, that's beautiful.
There we go. Ooh. Next. Gotta put a little more oil on it because Ratatouille loves oil. So this is just a mix of olive oil. There's a little bit of garlic and a little bit of thyme in there. You just kind of drizzle it all over.
Wow.
Just try and get as even of a coating as you possibly can.
Mm-hmm.
Oh my God, this is so nice. I hope Nicole likes this.
If she doesn't, I'm gonna throw hands with her.
I know, we're gonna fight. Got a little salt and pepper. Kind of to taste, so we'll just.
Love it.
Little pinches around. Yeah, little pinches.
Yeah. I like a good amount of salt.
I love me some sodium.
Yeah.
We're done. Ish. I mean, we're pretty much, you know, it's oil. We gotta bake this sucker so we can get those veggies nice and soft.
Mm-hmm.
So we are gonna put foil over this and just make sure you really like, this isn't a loose foil situation because we wanna make sure it cooks and that no moisture escapes.
Yep.
And while I'm doing this, would you mind preheating our oven to 275, please?
275. Beep, 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 beep.
So really make this tight. We are going to bake this at 275 for about 2 hours.
What?
Yeah, I know. You want to make sure everything's really nice and soft. Mm-hmm. And then after about 2 hours, when it seems like those veggies are getting nice and soft, you're gonna remove the foil, keep baking it for another 30 minutes or so till it gets nice and browned on top.
Ew.
Here we go, lift it together.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
A beautiful baby.
Have a wonderful nap.
Yay.
Ratatouille's in the oven. I think now we just gotta kind of prep the space for Nicole, maybe clean some things. Oh, excuse me.
Oh.
What are you wearing?
It's just as I suspected. Shut it down.
What?
Wait,
what do you mean? No.
Shut it down.
We're not even done yet.
I am the health inspector.
I took a shower. I'm clean.
Let me smell.
Yeah, smell her.
All right, that's clean. However, that's not what I mean. Prove that you're real chefs.
Are we not?
Right or now? I'll shut this kitchen down.
No, we don't. We can't have that happen. Okay, we'll prove it.
No, literally, our jobs depend on it.
Literally.
Kenny's job depends on it.
Yes, it does.
French Ember's gonna steal my job.
Oh, not French Ember. That's not me. I'm the health inspector.
No.
So you better do what I say to make sure that.
You guys look so familiar, and your accents are almost the same.
They're very different accents, actually.
Whatever you say.
A test!
All right.
Oh, God.
Jesus.
It is now time for the health inspector's baffling test of whether or not you are a chef.
Oh.
Please close your eyes and keep them closed.
Oh, no.
Now, a true chef sees beautiful colors and identifies flavors without seeing the food. Remember when Rat-a-tat-tat puts the stuff in his mouth and he sees beautiful colors?
Yes.
That's what we're doing.
When Remy sees those fireworks that go off. Yeah, for sure.
I don't know what movie you saw. Keep those eyes closed.
Okay.
I will place food in your mouth. Come in close and keep your eyes closed. My mustache is falling off.
Hearing the noises makes it 10 times worse.
Yeah.
Not knowing what she's doing.
And then hearing her freaking noises.
What is this?
Ah, you have. He
keep those eyes closed.
They're closed.
Open wide.
Mm-hmm. Oh. I don't like it. I think it's
a pear?
Blue cheese.
Oh my god, I think I'm gonna throw up.
I don't like that. I don't like that.
I think that's a pear.
It's blue cheese?
No.
No? Oh my god, okay. It's
cream
pear?
Cheese. It's cream cheese.
And olive oil, right?
It is pear, cream cheese, and olive oil. You may open your eyes. You have passed the test.
Oh my god.
And for that, I shall let you possess an A rating because you are real chefs.
Look it. We did it.
And now I shall be on my way to return another day.
It has been about 2.5 hours. Remember that first 2 hours was to soften the ratatouille. The last half an hour was just to let it bake and get a little brown and crispy on top. Shall we see how it looks?
We shall see.
We shall see. I don't know why I'm surprised. This is exactly what I intended and how I intermeant. We have a little vinaigrette that just consists of olive oil, thyme, and balsamic vinegar. This will be for our plating later, so I figured just might as well.
I'm gonna make a little...
Get her out of the way.
A little sauce.
Yeah.
Delish.
You can't have too much sauce. I feel like that's a constant theme with this show.
I love a good sauce.
I love a good sauce, too.
I have a cookbook that's this thick. And it's all about sauces.
I want to have a cookbook that's all about sauces and just call it Saucy Bitch.
There you go. Do it.
That's what I want. All right, I'll set that off to the side. The plating.
Oh god.
Oh no.
Do you know how to do this?
I've researched, but practice is different. But you've done it before. So I'm going to try my best to do it here. According to Thomas Keller, and his very fancy cookbook, we are going to grab like a little stack of them, including the sauce at the bottom. Mm-hmm. And then as I plate it, I'm going to rotate it like 90 degrees to try and fan it out. And that's it. It's going to be that simple. It's all gonna be so good. Because we want to get that nice little kind of circular, kind of spiral pile going on like you see in the movies. Right. And then if that fails the spatula,
plating tweezers!
Plating tweezers!
Because that's what all 5-star restaurants use.
100%. I don't want to cut this because it's so pretty. So I'm just gonna get a nice little pile here.
Oh yeah.
And then, oh yeah, that's just gonna stick right on there. Here we go. So professional, so clean, so nice.
Because you also want to think about height. Kind of want it to stand up a little bit more. So I'm going to grab another nice little chunk.
We need to impress Nicole.
We need to impress Nicole.
This needs to be perfect. There is no room for error here.
No.
This is up to your decision at home, how you'd like to plate it. If you want to plate it like the movie, it's kind of spiraled and fanned out and nice and tall. And like the movie, Ash went and got us some chives to put right on top.
Beautiful. There we go.
Next, we have this little vinaigrette mixture with the piper rod, so we're just kind of
nice thin little ribbon around the outside.
Nice thin little ribbon.
Beautiful.
I'm just gonna get the chunks. I'm gonna get the chunks around.
Yep. All right, and the final garnish, of course, is our lovely. There we go.
Oh, she's pretty. We'll put this off to the side.
Yep.
Ratatouille.
Okay, I'm freaking out.
Don't freak out, we got this.
What am I missing? I'm missing something. Fork! Ash, we need a fork.
Oh my god, what will we do?
I feel like this is just like a bear. I think I'm ready.
Big smiles.
Confidence.
We got this.
For sure, holding $30,000 bottle of wine. That's fine, let's do it.
All right, Nicole Ego.
Mademoiselle.
Zut alors! There's a rat in the kitchen?
Whee! She's very clean. Very clean rat. Very clean.
I took a shower.
She took a shower. You can smell her if you want. Umber did.
I have brought my own mouse.
Oh my god.
Oh my god, it's Minnie!
Oh,
we are here to taste the ratatouille. Ooh. I don't know what this accent is. It's a zero.
Ratatouille. I believed it.
We'll get this here. We'll get a fork. I guess, do you want some wine, Mouse?
Yes, please.
Do my drink to the top, please.
Thank you.
Ooh.
Chateau.
Cheval Blanc.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I like that.
Oh, very nice. Ooh.
Is this the perfect pairing for ratatouille?
The left
Chenal Blanc.
47 is the best pairing for
Ratatouille.
Ratatouille. Okay, wine, that's fine. That's okay. You can drink a lot of that.
That's good. Do we dig in?
Please. I'll go right ahead.
Wait,
yeah.
Have you had Ratatouille?
And I am Nicole Ego. Of course I have had Ratatouille. Favorite. It is my favorite dish.
I didn't know that it was just vegetables. I thought it was a layer of pepperoni. So when I found out it was vegetables, it broke my heart when I watched Ratatouille.
I picked a good mouse.
So thank
you. Yes,
you did.
You had Kimmy.
Well, little mouse.
All right.
Please enjoy.
Kimmy's job is on the line.
Mm-hmm. Yep, it's fine. No, no deal. I'm totally chill.
I smell a little balsamic.
Oh wow. Vegetables?
Oh, I know.
Wow.
Tomat?
Is that cucumber? Cucumber?
Nope.
No. Damn it. Dude, I suck at this.
Is there onion in it?
There's onion.
There's onion.
Garlic.
I told you that's
garlic.
How she says it. She does say it that way. You're so right.
All right.
Ooh.
Chess.
Oh my god.
It's good.
Oh my god.
Yes.
Oh my god.
Yes. You like it good.
That's so good.
I deem this dish delicious.
Yes! Let's go! I got a job! I got health insurance still! Let's go!
Yeah.
You got PTO!
Yeah, PTO!
PTO!
Oh my god!
Oh my god, I'm so relieved.
I did not do Kimmy's job. I was a big bluff. I'm so glad I don't have to do it. Congratulations.
Oh, oh my god! Thank you for jumping around. So nice! Yes. Do you guys want to try the Ratatouille?
Can I
have some gel? Yeah!
Oh. Alright.
This is a celebration.
Celebration.
So good. Yeah. If you don't like vegetables, don't worry, you'll like it now. I'm not even joking.
Sante?
Sante!
Oh my god. Thank you guys so much for watching PDF Chef Ratatouille. God damn, I did. I kept my job. It's all good. Let us know in the comments if you want to see any other types of foods or any other IPs. Let us know if you would make this at home because you can do it. Trust me. You can do it. I did it. You can do it. Anyone can do it.
Anyone can do it.
Truly.
I couldn't do this.
Except for Ember, apparently.
Oh, Ember could do this.
French Ember seemed way more confident than regular Ember. Oh, wow. I was going to have a bite, but
I ate it.
Too delicious.
So sorry.
So,
bye.
Let's drink some wine. Look, let's go back over here. Oh, don't.